So I know I haven't made a video in so long. If any of you guys follow me on Instagram, then you'll know why I haven't been posting videos lately. So I'm gonna start off doing my eyebrows and eyes first. The reason why I'm gonna do that is so that any fallout that happens doesn't get on your foundation and you end up having to remove the under eye area and completely redo it anyway. I'm gonna use this really ugly headband to put my hair back.
Yay!
So I'm gonna start off with my eyebrows. Complimentary is it right there. That's great. So I'm gonna use Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in Blonde. Yes, I do still have blonde even though I dyed my hair. This is a really good transition color for the front, and then I just usually darken it with this Urban Decay Brow Box in Brown Sugar using the darker color. The whole concealer part of cleaning up their eyebrows. Instead, I've been using eye primer. The reason why I've been doing that is because it's less cakey, because you're not applying concealer and then applying eye primer on top of that for when you do your eyeshadow. It's just eye primer and it still does the same job. So I'm gonna go in with Core Cosmetic eye primer. This eye primer is so amazing. It is super pigmented. It gets rid of your veins completely, just like the MAC paint pots, and it lasts like a year. I've had this for probably 4 months now and it's not even halfway gone. With that being said, I'm just going to clean up the eyebrows and also apply it all over my lid. The veins in my eyelid are completely vanished now rather than this eye. Yeah, it's amazing. I'm going to apply tape right here going up to my eyebrow. The reason why I use tape, or why most makeup artists use tape, is obviously to create a crisp line, and it makes gel liner and liquid liner so much easier, and you always get it perfect every time. I want the tape to match up with the end point of your eyebrow. Anastasia Beverly Hills Tamana Dress Your Face Palette. I'm going to go in with this color Brush just to highlight the brow bone. I'm going to apply that right under my eyebrow. When you are doing any smoky eye, or really any eye of any sort, ever, forever, you're gonna be using a transition color. A transition color is gonna be a light brown, a light gray, any neutral toned color that you're going to buff into your crease. So the transition color that I'm going to use is Bangle from Dress Your Face Palette. It's just a light brown. And I'm going to use Pro Blending Brush from Sephora, number 27. I'm gonna take a more darker color, chocolate, from the same palette. And I'm holding it at the bottom of the brush, so when you go like back and forth, you just kind of like a psycho. So just go back and forth like this. Along the line of the tape and going down to your lash line. You're just gonna run it along that. I'm gonna go in with black. So you're gonna go on with Noir. This is a very, very, very pigmented color specifically from this palette. You're gonna treat it like winged liner. So start on the outside of the tape and then go in like that. And then just kind of fill it in. So literally you're just going down. And you're gonna take a little bit and pull it into your crease like that. You're gonna wanna go in with another blending brush. This is the same brush I was using before. I love this brush because it's kind of tapered at the ends and it allows you to get in the crease very easily. And just start going back and forth. I'm gonna go in with L'Oreal's Infallible Eyeshadow in Eternal Sunshine. It's just a really pretty gold color. And they're like extremely, yeah, look at that. Now I'm gonna go in with a very light shimmery color. Blush from the same palette is the perfect color too. As you can see, I've already hit pan. I'm like obsessed with it. So I'm just gonna go in with that and apply that on the opposite side of where I applied the gold, all the way going into my tear duct. I'm going to use this gel liner by L'Oreal. It lasts creamy a lot longer than the Maybelline gel liner. I'm kind of doing the same I did with the black eyeshadow, but not as much product. And with that same blending brush, and blend into the eyeshadow. After that's done, I'm going to take a small thin pencil brush, and I'm going to go in with Bangle again and lightly go on the crease with that color. I'm going to line my lash line. Now you can finally remove this sticky tape. So obviously these eyelashes aren't the most dramatic eyelashes, but they work. I'm using Almay Smart Shade Perfect and Correct Primer. This is going to get rid of any redness. Then using a beauty blender and Makeup Forever HD foundation. I love this foundation because it's kind of a sheer foundation and works perfectly if you're going to cream, highlight, and contour your face, which is exactly what I'm going to be doing today. This concealer is specifically made not to crease. Obviously, I'm going to use MAC Longwear Concealer. I'm sure you guys already knew I was going to use that because I use it all the time. And I'm just going to apply this in my T-zone using the other end of the Beauty Blender. And then apply that in any blemishes that I have. Obviously, my mountain of zit, I'm going to apply that right here. I'm sure you guys have heard about makeup artists raving about these cream contour kits by Anastasia Beverly Hills. I do have all three shades in light, medium, and deep. My shade is light, so I'm going to highlight with this color. I'm going to use my pointed foundation brush by Real Techniques. So I'm going to do kind of an upside down triangle with this right under both of my eyes. I'm gonna go in with this bottom middle color. It is a shade darker than my actual skin tone. I'm going to start contouring my face. So I'm going to start at the top of my ear, going to where the corner of my lip is. I like to round out my apples of my cheeks, so I'm going to start making that shape. Then to create like a cool shade, I'm going to use the very darkest shade, and I'm going to apply this under where I contoured. Then I'm going to use this blush color, Cool Pink. It's the top right color, and I'm gonna apply that right between the contour and the highlight on my cheeks. Okay, so now it is time to blend it all together. Just start blending it out. To apply translucent powder in my T-zone using Makeup Forever's HD translucent powder and Makeup Forever's, it looks like this. Okay, now I'm going to powder contour using the Anastasia Beverly Hills powder contour kit. So I already went ahead and applied some Mineral Loose Blush in Peach Pink by Core Cosmetic. Okay, so I'm going to use the color Bangle, and I'm just going to apply that on the outer corner of my eye. Then I'm going to go in with Gilded again. Now I'm going to outline my inner tear duct. This takes a lot of practice, so this part is obviously off. It's gonna look something like that. A regular eye pencil. This one is L'Oreal's Smoldering Eye Pencil in Black. Yeah, and then you can just apply some mascara on your bottom lashes. So I'm gonna outline my lips with this nude lip liner. Okay, then I'm gonna go in with Anastasia Beverly Hills Liquid Lipstick in Pure Hollywood. But once that is done drying, I'm gonna go in with the same liquid lipstick from Anastasia Beverly Hills, except this color is in Milkshake. So this is an even more pinky color, and it's a lighter nude color. I'm going to create an ombre lip, so I'm applying this in the middle of my lips. So that really is the ending look. It is obviously full coverage, full glam makeup. I don't expect anyone to really know how to cream contour senior year of high school. So other than cream contouring, you can just apply, you can just do your regular foundation routine, and the eye look is mostly the prime thing for this video. I will be uploading a more natural prom tutorial, and I really hope you guys watch it, subscribe to my channel, and like if you liked it. If you don't, then I'm sorry. Thank you all for watching, and I love you all so, so much. If any of you guys follow me on Instagram, then you'll... What is that? Seriously, what the fluff? Seriously, what the fluff? So I'm gonna do a couple pumps. that's not the same thing. What's up, girl? What's your name? How are you doing today?